Are you sure? Are you sure you're ready for this? Well, you're close. It's more around 30 seconds. Yeah, it's pretty bad. That's why normally when like I ask a question or something, sometimes you'll see me just kind of sit and do nothing for a second because I'm just looking and I'm waiting. I'm like, eventually? Eventually? it's just Twitch delay. It's just the delay from, you know, capturing my game here, streaming it to Twitch, uploading it on the servers, and then getting it out to people. All right, I guess so. You're good. Cool deal, I got everything running. I just gotta fix a few more things and then we'll get started. Man, that music's too crazy. Sure, that'll work for now. Okay, I just need to make sure everything works first. Looks like we should be good to go then. Just pop that down a few and also kill that. Alright, I had to let that go on for an extra second. That was good. Oops. That's not the right one. Alright. So, when we last left off, some things happened. We prevented a terrible tragedy. And oh boy. Oh boy. I just don't even know what to say anymore, so we're just gonna hit continue and see what the fuck happens next.
Film, whoa. Little pieces
what
of
the
time.
Fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave me alone. Max? Chloe?
I fucking forgot about that headbutt.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait, is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max? Tell me everything.
Tell me everything, yes. Oh, man. Alright. It is a story-based game. You're right. Wake the fuck up. Damn right, snooze. Not ready to play yet. Oh, all right. Oh, what up, Square Enix? Nice to see you this morning. I like to wake up every morning to a fair share of Square Enix. Oh, and what up? Don't nod. Episode 2, Out of Time. Wa-na-na! Who the fuck sleeps with bracelets on? You got issues, Max. Time to start the motherfucking day. Let's do it.
No amount of rewind will keep me clean. I still need a shower.
What? Nah, first thing in my mind was, we can travel backwards in time? Who needs showers? Oh, damn. Two text messages? Ooh, Jesus. Alright. Where'd we leave off on this conversation? Oh, man. Oh, there's just shit happening right now. Okay. Hell is an ass buster breakfast. Good lord. Ah, yeah, see, Chloe knows what's up. It is 7:30 in the morning. Too much. On my way. Yo, Max, don't lie. We just rolled up out the bed. We are not on the way anywhere. Don't forget to water the plant. Don't drown
anything. Even with all this crazy shit going on,
water a plant?
It's so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed.
Oh yeah.
Though, secretly,
thankfully, Moms did remind me to water the plant, because I would have forgotten. That action will have consequences. Like the plant living. Never looked at these.
I can't keep my eyes open.
Whoa.
But I know there's a scientific answer.
Quantum entanglement? Come on. It's like 50% scientific effort and then 50% just, you know, doodles and scatterbrain. Time is like a river. That's good. Whoa. Yep. Not happening. Clothes are in the dresser.
It'll be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games.
Ooh. Alright. I mean, that's right. Got a shower first. Brain.
Okay, Max. Let's hit the showers now.
And stuff.
Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again.
Maybe. I don't wear the froggy watch, though. Might want to upgrade. Should we bring the clothes with? No. Alright. We need the phone. No, we don't. Journal? Yeah, I know. I should take a shower. We've got that. Okay, so read this. Oh! Jeez. Whoa. We're gonna save all that for another time. Oh boy, I don't know how I didn't notice all that.
Yeah. Morgan, seriously, do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it. Consider it done.
That was good. Thanks for that, Victoria. Really woke me up this morning. Alright, I remember my place is like right next to the showers, right?
Ow!
sorry. Bullying is never okay. That's a terrible thing. Damn it, that was funny. Yo, what up, Kate? Morning. You are just barely alive right now.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
I'm here, she said.
Anytime.
Oh, Jesus.
That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Well, here's the idea behind that. Yes, I may have forgotten that I can go back in time and could have prevented that, but let us not forget the comedic genius instilled in that. Someone thought at 7:30 in the morning, let me throw this toilet paper roll at this chick real quick, watch this. And it worked, because it was unfortunately hilarious. It's like when someone slips and falls, man. Oh, she's plotting. Oh, shit.
What's up, Kate?
Oh, son of a bitch.
Cool. That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
Hey now, I will bust out this shower and ruin your morning.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
Jesus Christ!
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
But she purchased a domain to host a fucked up video of somebody. Allegedly somebody. Let's not immediately jump to conclusions here.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book.
Well, let's not forget about this. Jesus Christ.
Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Golly. Rachel is a whore. Fuck, bitches are savage. Good lord. I mean, don't get me wrong, people have said some pretty savage things in time, but Jesus. What am I doing? Oh, yeah, my book. Ugh. I bet this isn't gonna be an everyday affair. Why can't we just write Victoria's a slut on the fucking board? Is that not okay?
No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up? After I find Kate's book.
We rearrange some pictures on a wall. She comes at us with spray paint? Yeah, that's spray paint. And writes bitch. How fucking rude.
Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed.
Eh. Serve your head on a platter.
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal.
Oh, fucking Nathan did that? What? Excuse me? Yo, how did Nathan even get over to the girl's side? We gonna have to be taught. Don't make me go. I'll go to the principal twice. I know he's useless, but I'll do it just for fuck. Shits and
my
giggles.
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
Oh, we're looking for a book. That's right. Oh, man. I don't even remember what book we're looking for.
No book here.
Darn it.
And nothing here.
Damn it, Max, where'd you leave this book? Oh, what the fuck? Calm and carry. Oh. We might as well put clothes on while
maybe
we're here.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
There's no book here. Oh. Oh,
of
Jesus.
Just spilled soda on Kate's book.
Yep,
better
just
fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to our list of problems.
The only thing I don't like is the thought that I'm gonna have to move it.
Be gone, thou soft drink.
She can't, Max can't just be smart enough to know.
Aha, you sneaky
oh,
book.
Whoops.
You're mine.
Let me just be a little more careful in grabbing this book. No, it's like,
now
let me get this class out of the way,
because
I'm not gonna be able to handle it.
As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
Except no, because we still said we would meet Chloe at the cafe in 40 minutes, and it's, oh man, how long has it been now? I know there was no short shower. Private number? Oh god. I know where you sleep. Oh man, we all go to the same school and live in dorms, and you know where I sleep.
Oh shit.
Never would have
guessed.
Now I'm
getting anonymous threats, it never ends. This has to be from Nathan, but it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger.
Danger?
If I'm not already.
Who the fuck's room is this? Juliet. Oh, what up, Dana? Yeah. Is that thing still in? I'm just gonna dig in your trash real
and
quick.
Pathetic.
Oh, God. Oh, I read that. Crash now. What up? I'm gonna. Ha!
Speaking of
holy
Halloween,
shit.
Look at all this makeup. At least Dana knows how to use it.
I'm just gonna. Don't
who
mind
will survive
me.
And what will be left of them? Don't say that out loud, dork.
Did you just say that out loud?
That would be fun to put skulls and ghosts all over Blackwell.
Ghoul power!
Like I could pull this look off?
Jesus.
Hello, Victoria.
Costume Central. Yo, rollerblades? Sick.
Rollerblades! Oh, I wanted to be a derby girl, but I almost broke my feet just putting them on.
What the fuck? Ow. Max,
that
we gotta
so
talk.
That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
It's not cool, bro.
That's so not cool.
I didn't get wasted on camera and get busy with the Vortex Club.
Oh, Jesus.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché.
Ooh, drop the
now
mic.
Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
Can't even look at me anymore. Flex.
Are you sure? I thought you'd be pissed.
Not at you. Part of me was almost disappointed because I built up so much rage.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit.
Yeah.
Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
Though she could be legitimate. Julie could be that one follower.
Ada takes her Blackwell spirit seriously.
Who, you know, is always willing to play both fields. If you know what I mean.
What's happening, Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Oh, this sounds like such a motherfucking trap. But you know what? We're gonna be reckless and we'll put this on the maybe.
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
Okay.
Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
I know, Brooke. Have I spoken to you?
Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
No, not at all. He's my friend, not my mother.
True. And Warren really loves to talk meteorology with me, since I'm one of the few who can talk back. Talk to you later, Max.
You are useless. Could go give this book back. I would like to see. Oh yeah, we still got some more of these to go through at some point. But these are what I'm looking for here. I don't want to miss these like last time. I want to try to nail all these. I want to get a good look. All right, let's go. Wait, can I go in other rooms?
Go away! People sleeping!
Clearly not.
Clearly not a morning person.
Just gonna knock on everyone's door.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
Oh, I'm gonna be really disappointed.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Oh, Jesus, mother of... I've got to erase that shit again. Oh, biscuits. Oh, she plays the violin. Sick. Oh, she can't even look at herself. Savage.
Why did she cover up the mirror?
Oh, man.
She can't look at herself?
Oh, man.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
Can't look at herself. Oh, hey. Someone does have a rabbit. Yeah, I have a feeling this alleged video might be for real, unfortunately.
Ouch. She left out Amnation.
Oh, I'm just gonna... There we go. Oh, there's that. Spirit or devil could have prepared me for what you have done in that videotape. And like a Jezebel, you released your harlot image before God's eye. I will pray with my church for your soul to be saved from eternal hellfire. Auntie Marsh. Such a nice script and everything for such a savage letter. Oh, that sucks. Oh, Kate, what did you do?
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Oh, boy. Should we just break it out? Should we just roll with it right out the gate? You know, God, I feel bad about this, but here we go.
What about this video? And I swear I haven't watched it.
I can't even watch it, Max.
Why is this an option? Okay, you know what? I just have to, and then we're gonna rewind, but...
Should I watch it? Just for posterity?
Are you kidding? You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but... Tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
So why would you go?
Lapse of sanity? I just thought I could meet some new people.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Are you sure it was...
She got Casby'd.
I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here in my bag.
Lol. Just cause. Hold up. Bam. There we go. So, yeah, that's, oh, boy. I mean, on a positive note, at least the video is just something she did at the party, and apparently it was just her making out with people, and the really, really fucked up shit didn't get videotaped, but I'm just trying to look at the silver lining.
That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes.
I'm uncomfortable in here, Kate. I'm sorry, I need to leave. I also need to put the book away.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Oh, man. Rough. Okay. So I could tell her to go to the police, but the problem is the same thing that goes with this whole Nathan Prescott guy being a rich douchebag, is that might not do anything unless we have some, like, solid, like, got him. I'm gonna add to that really fucked up statistic and say, look for proof.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
Also that.
But I know I was drugged. That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, no,
I'm fucking Kate. Sorry, Kate.
I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems
I didn't fail. Rule number one, a party going.
So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help.
Trying to be nice to you, girl, but you're
so I can walk down the halls with people
making this fucking rough on me.
Thanks, Max.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Oh, sucks to suck. Sorry, Kate. You gotta deal with the hand you're dealt, my friend. All right. Oh, shit. Hold on. 7:38. Okay. We have a small amount of time. We need to... It's that toilet paper roll. Okay. I know exactly where that next one's gonna be. Alright. Time to go. Oh. What up, Samuel? You chilling with the birds, homeboy? What's good? Morning.
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together.
Samuel knows what's
Samuel
up.
Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
You don't have to whisper to me, Samuel.
Don't laugh, but... I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me, like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Samuel's gonna end up being my time guide. Oh boy. The struggle. So real. Oh shit, it's Warren. Alright, maybe he won't see us, hold on. I'm just gonna... Oh shit, he's gonna see us. Oh, what? What?
This is Nathan's father. This is a message to let you know that attempts to slander and blackmail my son will be met with many lawyers and legal ramifications. You're not the first student at Blackwell to try this. I hope you're the last. Consider this a final, polite warning.
What a fucking douche. Ugh. He's gonna... Run! Ah.
Corin.
What are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting.
No, yeah, trying to get the shit kicked out of him.
I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
Son of a bitch.
That was intense.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast.
I burped something.
I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
She's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
Because he's a psycho.
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
No, come on, Max.
Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
You know, I get what the game would drive at with Warren. He's a real good guy, but I...
No, I don't think I can concentrate on going out to the movies. I just feel like escaping.
Fine. Be a damn dirty human. I'll go eat myself.
All right, bye, Warren.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Or all of the above. This small town's got some fucked up shit going on. Especially when... What is this bus driver? Oh, okay, now that's that one kid we know. I thought that was the bus driver. And I was like, who is this guy right now? It's good. Wait, where the fuck am I? Where's the school bus taking me? I know I'm trying to go to the diner, but.
Don't you know that I'll be around to guide you through your weakest moments to leave them behind? Turning nightmares, only shadows. Cast some light.
Bus, that is not how you merge onto an intersection. Excuse me? Yo, this bus is on some reckless shit right now. He barely even yielded. He was half into the intersection and was like, oh, let me slow down a little bit. Oh, that wind. Oh, that looks so cool. Fuck, this game looks so nice. Ah, man. Two whales is a gas station?
Don't try to take it from me.
Oh, okay. Oh, shit.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time.
Oh!
Looks like, nope, I don't want to go there.
Not the face I was expecting to see to my left. My man's You know what? What's good?
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
Well, don't tell everyone you have that ticket. You don't look too powerful. What up, lady?
Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got here. Oh, thank you.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
Oh, man. God, are we late again? Oh, my Jesus Christ. I'm so late at this point. Yep. Oh, come on, take that a little more to the right. Get that cool sun flare in there. Excuse you! Rude? Golly. People nowadays. I really want to walk around town now that I'm in town, but fuck me, I go to the diner. Alright, we'll talk to one more guy. What up, dude? You look crazy. How you doing?
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Oi!
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
Oi, he speaks a pirate's garb.
What is this guy? Oh.
You have your own boat?
I call her the Bali High. I've kept a hold of her in these lean days. Might be all the time we've got left.
I thought one of Arcadia Bay's main exports was fish.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
Aye, now I have to go pirating. I don't fish no more.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
You're a funny guy, fisherman. You know what? We'll grab a flyer. Hold on.
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
And she won't even grab one. Talks about... Max, we can get along. We can do this thing. That's good.
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
Butt crack. Can't see it too well, but there's a butt crack there. Trevor and Justin. Where are their other two friends, Kyle and Sean? Perhaps Sam. Yo, how is she still not here? I thought I was late as fuck. Banjo tune. This is how you start the morning.
Forgot about the fishing wall of fame.
White sturgeon caught by Dick Weber. A steelhead trout caught by Andy Berry. And a Chinook salmon caught by Rick Conrad. Look at all these old ass baked goods that have been baked throughout the week and left up here.
Drool. Want everything.
This game is great. I could fuck around for ages. Oh, what up? Oh, you're gonna be great.
Did you catch any big ones today?
If by big you mean none, then sure. I caught a lot of big ones today.
Oh,
now let me
shit.
Mourn over my eggs.
Oh, you are not a friend. That is not mayonnaise. Excuse me? What kind of fucking game are we playing right now? That is not mayonnaise. I wish I could zoom in. And the mustard and you know it game. But is the hot sauce gonna be... The hot sauce looks like it says pepper. I hope it's gonna be like pepper sauce. Weird lady. Yes, can I sit down with weird lady? No? Alright.
Hello there to you!
Whoa.
Such a beautiful day. Oh yeah, it's gonna be a super day. Enjoy
Ah, yeah. Ah, yeah, next thing you know, you're gonna be opening up. Opening up, skirting slits. Kate Marsh, love you long. Oh, can I erase this one? Damn it. Sarah Palin. Rachel A. owes me a blowjob. So does your mom.
Gross.
Holy shit. It's another doe. I found fire walk with me. See, I'm all about bathroom. We're gonna call it art. That's always fun. I mean, not things like this, but I mean, that's funny. That's definitely funny.
That graffiti has been here forever.
Things like that. Like, nah, so does your mom, though. Great comeback for a wall. But you don't scratch the mirror. Come on, people need to use what? Arcadia Gay sucks dick.
Thank you, redneck poet.
Arcadia Gay sucks dick. And the Mexicans are taking all our gerbs. Let's watch the news real quick.
Coming up at noon, KBay 7 News will explore the mystery of yesterday's unusual snowfall on a warm and sunny late afternoon that confused and delighted Arcadia Bay residents. We'll be talking with Portland meteorologists in the area and look at some of your fun video reactions to the odd snow flurry. Who knows? Maybe Mother Nature was pranking us all. So, stay tuned to KBay 7 News for the real story.
You know, at least that newscaster didn't come at me with like, you know, maybe Mother Nature's trying to pull her own viral video, like some kind of tagline like that. That would have, I probably would have vomited.
You'd never know how weird this town is by these postcards.
Oh, no, my dear Max. It's a small town. Everyone knows it's weird. What up, guy?
What do you want? I feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
Wah, wah, wah. What up, cop?
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Look a little lost, nigga? I live here. I'm just hungry.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese?
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard she even just got busted with pot in her room.
Oh, Jesus Christ. What is it? Did her fucking stepdad, did he report it to the police? My stepdaughter's been using the pot. Y'all should come down here and confiscate this marijuana and dispose of it appropriately. Jesus Christ.
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner.
Yeah,
Joyce
no.
Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell the loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. Just kidding.
Just kidding.
Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
Who?
Not really.
That's good. She's not a bad person. She's had hard times, but there's no excuse for burning things.
What?
Her dad died.
My dad died when I was 13. I never burned garbage cans or tagged signs. Joyce is a great mother. Chloe just isn't paying attention.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
When the cop tells you to avoid the RV, we're not talking to truckers. We don't need that today. Just sit the fuck down. I guess we probably could have said hi to, you know, Chloe's mom, who we probably definitely know.
And there she is.
Yep.
Lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
Damn. No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, no. Kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. Again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man. He just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him, but... Don't be so harsh on Chloe.
It's good you're here. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's gotta rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Why? What did Chloe tell you?
Well, it's not what she told me. It's what I saw with my own two beautiful eyes.
Well, Chloe texted me that David slapped her yesterday.
He feels awful. And he will be punished.
Mm-hmm.
But Chloe does sure push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
This 18-year-old girl is giving this hardened military veteran so much trouble that he has to hit her. Fucking excuse.
That's no excuse Joyce. To hit a girl. He's an adult.
I don't like it either, Max. David swore it would never happen again.
Oh, yep.
He's true to his word.
Oh, sure he is, Joyce.
I just want us to be a family
soon.
I guess it's all about time.
I think you're right, Joyce.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
David sucks, but Joyce is not much better. Jesus. Be a good mother and protect your child. Get away from fuckboy, David. David. Alright, Belgian waffle or bacon omelet. Oh. What are you thinking, Max? You got that fit. You know what? You don't look too adventurous. So I'm thinking the bacon omelet isn't for you. We'll go Belgian waffle.
The last
then.
Good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
I love waffles. And I wish I had coffee. Scopel, you wanna bring me a cup of coffee? That'd be super dope.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
One Belgian waffle at 12 o'clock high.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
Good God, Belgian. Okay, we didn't get the fried fish. How much is this waffle? Hold up. Because things on here are pretty expensive for a diner. Like, a dollar for all, like, the drink prices? Appropriate. But you're gonna tell me...
I love the delish anticipation of breakfast.
The delish anticipation of breakfast.
Warren must have been here.
I'm gonna talk about that next time I eat breakfast.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
Ah, he changed my music. I saw him. It was him right there in the blue hat and the blue shirt. He walked over and he changed my music.
No beer? What kind of dive is this?
All right, it's pretty banging, but still.
Incoming.
Banjos. Don't throw it at me. Bring my waffles to me nicely.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still, ooh, she even put the strawberries on that?
When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh.
Miss Joyce, you do make a fine waffle, or whoever your cook is back there.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh god, here it comes.
Got him.
Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me
Sergeant Pepper!
Tell him, David, if you don't want to be lectured.
Fucked.
You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
Ooh. Damn, Mama got you.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox?
Right? Thanks. See, Chloe knows what's up. That's why Chloe is my waifu.
Now that that's out of the way.
Unfortunately, Chloe, like, that's
Let's
a little much for, like, 8 in the morning, even for me.
And I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have x-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets.
I don't even know what's in my pockets. Awesome.
Okay, Max. Impress me.
Wait. What? Oh, man. Do you think I can get another lucky guess? All right, let's see. Chloe... Well, she would have had to have driven here, so I'd like to think she'd have keys, but I also think she'd have gum, but we're gonna go with keys.
Your car keys. Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Oh, your keychain? She's got bullets on her necklace, so I'm gonna think fascination with bullets, keychain.
Bullet. Just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max.
Fuck!
Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets.
Cigarettes, keys, change. Damn it.
That even made me want to believe you.
Oh, yeah? Hold on. Let me take
a
look.
Max, study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
Alright, key with a panda. A little dirty, too. Jesus, Chloe, come on now. Cigarettes open. $0.86. Ha. And a warning parking ticket? What? You know, I wish those were real. I don't know how in-depth this is gonna go, and I hope it's not too bad, because... Oh, well. Hold on. Just in case. Forget I have a whiteboard next to me. Cool. Alright.
You got this, Max. Chloe's mine.
Come on. Faster.
faster.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Cigarettes?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
Ah, I knew to count the cigarettes. In my head, I was like, fuck. I was like, let me count how many cigarettes she got left. Okay, hold on. I know the bottom row was filled. And when I... this is where smoking helps. Okay, so when I smoked, how many rows? There was 4 rows, which means in a pack of 20 cigarettes, it's 5 per row. So that means she had 7 cigarettes.
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes.
Cool. Bow!
Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Not good knowledge to have, but it worked. Alright, keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Yeah, I know. You have a panda.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
You have money.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
What did I say? 86 cents?
86 cents.
That's right. Living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
Parking ticket.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time.
Sure, her fucking mind just got blown.
Chills all over my neck. You have powers.
Yep.
Take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
Oh my God! 2 sausage links, an omelet, 2 pieces of toast, 1 slice of bacon.
Good save.
What else did she get?
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
All right, David Bowie. Or no. That's incorrect.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler, so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
What are we gonna
now
do?
Pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments.
Oh,
so you can
boy.
Dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Ha.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That's the best song I've
this
heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now, pay attention to everything that happens
yeah,
in the next
few
moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Alright.
I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Cool. Okay, so... Trucker drops his mug.
The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
Then an alert on the cop's radio. But he doesn't leave, his partner leaves. Okay, I get it.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Okay, and then after that, the boys fight, and she stops them?
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
Kind of.
It's getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
And then, oh fuck, I did not look at the jukebox. I was pretty sure someone would have changed it, but it would have to be a fly would have landed on it. I like to think the trucker played a new song, but we're going to say a fly.
The jukebox goes crazy as a fly lands on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens.
I was paying attention to the weird lady going to the bathroom. Because I have written mug break, cop, slap fight, weird lady bathroom.
Oops.
Dude, did you right. break another cup? Kay. Really? No refill for you.
Watch that in a second. Cop gets the call.
Now I gotta take this call and leave my friend. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
It's a fucking cockroach. Son of a biscuit. I was really hoping this place is slightly more reputable.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones.
Don't make me rewind to do it again.
So, what are you waiting for?
Ah.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few months.
Oh, okay.
So you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
I didn't expect that at all.
I'm going to predict.
Yep. Okay. Trucker drops smoke.
The trucker drops.
So, what happens?
Partner leaves.
The cop.
Well,
and stops them.
Justin and Trev.
This is getting
And cockroach.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max.
Whoa, do I get to see a new angle from this now?
Oops.
Nice.
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang any no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Jesus Bro. Christ.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power.
No, let's not
you
do it anymore.
To guide you.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's.
As I said in the first episode, we probably shouldn't use this too much. Can't be good for us. Oh boy. Alright. Wait a minute. Oh yeah, I got the thing in the bathroom. Ooh. But there's a half-eaten donut somewhere. Checking the restaurant before I leave, because if there's a half-eaten donut here, I don't want to miss it.
I think I'm ready for thirds.
Jesus.
But you're only on your first.
My stomach plans ahead. My stomach plans ahead. What the fuck? Oh, we going? What's up? Yo.
Okay, Supergirl. Let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and pull to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit. Let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school?
Whoa.
I see how you roll. So go ahead. Chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with, too.
Oh, God. All right, you know what, Chloe? We're great friends, and I want to be friends, but I got a Kate Dust call. There's real
hey,
important shit going on
What's
right
up?
Now.
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
Oh, you for okay? the love of God, grow up.
I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your whole thing and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now, let's rock.
Man, fucking everybody got issues in this town.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument.
Oh, shit. Man, life is strange.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Yeah, fucking for real. Be.
Like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm and not in the revolution yet,
you,
Che.
You're like
you are the revolution
one beer
boss.
Deep at
so
age 17.
Best use and not abuse big, your power so, with yeah. test.
You're getting a little tipsy, aren't you?
Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
Ah.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Well, I see one. Oh no. Ah. Okay. Hey, look. Bottle. Found one. A bottle and a boat. I set up so high. Okay, got it. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, come on, Max.
Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking. Look what we have here.
Do I have to?
Cute little bottle for the taking.
Okay, well. Alright. Fuck you, bottle. Oh. You didn't see anything. Nope, not at all. Oh man, look at this crate. What if we were to move it over here?
Hello, bottle number one. One more to go.
It's a cute little guitar riff. Da-na-na.
No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay. Nope, I don't want to go there.
I wasn't trying to. Does realize she has a sticker on her little fucking strap that says cool story. That fucking says cool story. Holy balls.
Those shells look fresh.
Who's popping off shotgun rounds out here? Syringes? Who's also doing heroin out here? Good lord.
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground.
Also not okay.
I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy.
Oh, a bridge.
All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth?
Whoa. completely ignoring your statement.
Museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here.
Whoa. This is pretty fucking cool.
I don't want to intrude, but I was here. So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared.
Oh, Jesus.
I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
Oh, La La Land this
three
way.
Bottles left.
Fuck you. Yes, you. Oh.
Ouch.
Oh my god. Why do you respond to him so much, Max? It's killing me. Alright, I'll read it. No, don't send winky faces. Ah, damn it, Max. You're making this hard.
Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape.
Ugh.
That kind of hurts.
Well?
I can't see Chloe playing with makeup.
You say it hurt, Max, but again, you did move for a while. When you came back, you didn't. You weren't just like, hey, what's up, Chloe? I'm back. I'm your friend, remember? But no, you were like, no, I'm gonna be weird about it for a minute. So I can't sympathize with you, Max Sereno.
Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone.
Don't mind me, Chloe. I'm just wandering aimlessly, enjoying my time. Alright, I see there's a bottle up there, and I need to go get that plank, right? Yeah. Puzzles!
The Bigfoots were here.
I hope that's just the label and that isn't like a really full bottle, like a 2 liter that someone just left here, like a wasteful fool.
Way heavier than I thought.
Damn, girl. Hold on, how big is that? Damn. Shit. They fucking deadlifted that shit with ease. Golly, Max never skips arm day, but she doesn't go for build. She's just toning, it seems.
Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack.
Bottle in a haystack. That would be pretty easy. So, yeah, this is kind of like finding bottles in a haystack. Okay, sure. Or it's a motherfucking squirrel. Boo! Boo! I'm coming up there, motherfucker. Hold up. No, I'm not. All right. Three bottles. We need two more. Two more bottles. Time to put the brakes on the story, because I can't find... Oh, there's got to be some in the bed of the truck.
I don't want to go away.
Damn it. That answers that. Oh. Oh shit, is that the 142? Whoa. Wait, that means I missed the bone and the donut? Oh, man. I suck at this game.
So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now.
Arbitrary information. Ooh.
Beyond repair.
Oh.
Rest in peace.
RIP.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
More Arbor. Hey.
One more bottle to go.
And a whole new area. Ah, fuck. Oh, Jesus. Well, I mean,
wow, sir.
I guess, oh.
That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision.
Oh, man. That's not good.
That dough is the perfect photo op.
That's not good at all. Unless I'm crazy, that dough shouldn't show up on the film. Okay, bye. Huh. Huh.
This was an old school punk shirt.
I thought that was a clue or something. Alright, game. Spoon feed me the last bottle, please. And then we'll be out. Stump. I could sit on the stump? Oh, damn it.
It's so quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something. I just have to figure out the message.
Full honesty, from what we've seen thus far, Max, I believe the message to be get the fuck out of here. This is not the place for you.
There's a bonfire spot where people party around here.
Thank you, Max. But we... wait, didn't I already go over to that little... area? Because that was where she was like, oh, I see people were here. Otherwise, the bonfire area would be like somewhere here in the center. Oh, man.
I don't want to go that way.
Yep, sorry. I'm gonna say, wouldn't it be real tragic if I walked across the tracks while the train was coming? Eat shit and live.
Thanks for the tip.
Alright. Oh. What the fuck? Who's trying to kill me? Trying to hurt people. Hey, look,
I'm sure this is a popular party pit.
Why is it so secluded, though? Like, you definitely don't need to be sitting this close to a fire. The fire.
That frightened me a little bit.
Man.
Oh. That was almost bad. And good. Whoops. Do I have the bottle? I have the bottle. Hey. Oh, son of a bitch. Okay. Why am I dying? Uh-oh. Well, I broke it.
Max, rewind now!
I didn't want to go this far back, but, well. Jesus. What the fuck? Alright, we'll go that far. What the heck? Fine. I broke it. Oh, what the heck? Okay, are we done? Okay. Okay. Let's just think about this for a minute. Whoa. I'm so confused. Like, not crazy, right? I'm gonna go all the way back to that dot for some reason. But I'm just fucking any suggestions?
I'm sure this is a popular part.
Yeah, we've talked about that. I'm not okay. All the way? Alright. Lit on. And then we're back here. Man. I could try to, Oh no. Don't get myself stuck. Oh no. Uh oh.
Shit! I need to rewind and do something fast!
Uh-oh.
I have to rewind now.
So.
Shit. This is as far back as I can rewind.
It's dark. Oh, okay. So. So that just happened.
Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Oh. Cool. All right. Hold on. I need to do one thing real quick. I've destroyed this game for a second. Everything seems to be running fine, but OBS is not a fan of it. It keeps yelling at me. There we go. What up, Chloe? Let's shoot shit.
Thanks, Max.
God. Duper bumped it. Did you hear it? I know. Wait, you did.
One more for the road? You're serious about this. We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet.
Are
Max,
you?
You have to help me aim.
What? What, are you gonna miss and I'm gonna be like, okay, well,
show
you were a little
way
to the left on the first one.
I need to see you shoot first.
Oh, fuck. Oh, well, clearly to the left.
Show me the way, Max. Aim a bit to the right. Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max? Duh.
Wow!
Fucking cool. Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're gonna...
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Gonna give me a fucking aneurysm doing this stuff too much. But we'll do it.
Hey, Max?
Like, doesn't look nice. Above.
Right between the eyes.
It's like she's getting the worst migraine of her life all at once.
Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here.
Time for the most dangerous game. Oh.
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Okay, don't shoot the rim. That's made of metal. What is that? A plank? Okay, you can shoot that.
Hello?
Don't shoot the oil drum. Oh, shoot that monitor.
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet.
Ah, fuck yeah.
Old school. Lame.
Wait, lame? But... we gotta be careful about ricochets here, Pete. Ah, god damn it. All
right. Fine, since you won't play, I'm gonna shoot this barrel.
Oh, god.
Yawn.
Oh, please. Jesus. Fucking Christ.
Listen to those fat bullet beats.
Oh, what are you crazy? Trying to get us killed. She's still not a fan. Okay, fine. Fuck it.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now?
Oh, God. Ha!
Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tech.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like, never? So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
I need a target before
right.
I shoot.
I'll blow out the tire. Shit will probably get way too real.
Well, Max,
fuck it.
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death.
Yep. Huh. What I thought.
Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
Oh, shit. Oh, Jesus. Game, you can't get that loud all of a sudden. It scared the shit out of me.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again.
Do you, though?
I better go chat up Chloe.
Hold on. First. Photo op. Cool.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble? Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid. I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
Oh, God.
Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe?
Oh, fuck.
Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Oh. Rev it the fuck down, man.
Please step back.
Oh, Jesus, Max. You're not confident enough for this. Please put the gun down. This is how stupid shit happens. Wow. Really? Jesus Christ. Okay, no. We're not gonna shoot him just yet. Jesus. He hasn't done anything fucking stupid yet. He's an idiot, but Christ.
Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest.
Mm.
Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't
like
guns.
What the fuck was I gonna do?
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me.
Yeah. You're also not in jail. Though, for posterity's sake, we are gonna check. I just wanna know. Because what I really wanna know is, I don't feel like you actually shoot him. I feel like warning shot type deal. So we're gonna see. If we actually shoot him, then, fucking course not. What? What? Aww. Really? I thought... Okay. Guess not. Get in a truck, kids. Wait, where the fuck's Chloe? Back on the car. Aww. Lol. Oh, I see. I did go. I thought it didn't go back in time, and I was like, well, fuck me then.
Are you ready to do this?
We should jet before.
We have plenty of time to do anything we want, whenever we want. Make me proud, sister.
Yeah. And...
That is hilarious.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Man.
That was all six, wasn't it?
Kid, I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Whoa. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Yeah.
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
I mean, yeah. But in the end, if he tries to do anything and we do actually go to the cops,
Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now.
Oh, damn it.
Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
Whoa. Let's go. Though now, from what I remember from the little spoiler from the end of episode one, this is not good.
I'm glad there was no bullets in there.
You can just rewind time in your hand and stick that barrel right up Frank's ass. You have the power!
You're gross. Don't fall.
Oh, no, it's so cute. Oh.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk.
Let's sit on these live tracks.
Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
No.
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, did you see what just happened? I almost shot him. I know I could rewind, but Chloe, this is not playtime. No more guns.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers. Obviously don't get my pot from you, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Oh, Jesus.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Oh, no, we didn't have sex.
Oh, thank God.
Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I don't know anymore. My brain is so fried from all this. I need a mental enema.
Oh.
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Fuck. Did you get stuck? I never understand these situations.
What's that noise? The train.
Yeah, no shit, the train. Wait, aren't we at a track conjecture? No, wait, that's still not gonna fucking help us.
Find something!
Shit! I mean, I can rewind time. Maybe. Grimmar.
I can definitely use this bad boy.
I fucking hope so. Go.
Please, get me out of here.
Oh.
Get me out of here, Max.
I fucking want to. What do I do? Grimmar would definitely help, says Max. What? Do you want me? Do you want me to use this?
It's not locked.
Is that the idea? Oh, fuck. What is this?
I better find a tool to cut those wires.
Are you kidding me? Jill!
Can you move it with this crowbar? For real?
Fuck, I don't... Shut up, I don't know what I'm doing! Oh, shit! Oh, she's fucking ripped. I'm gonna use this time to look real quick, and we're just not gonna look out there. Okay, so we're gonna use the crowbar to open this door, but yeah. What? Oh! Ah! I don't.
Score.
Hi, shishubba. Nippers, nippers, get the nippers.
I can pull a total MacGyver.
You're fucking damn right. All right, is there anything else? Is there any fucking thing else we need in here? God, I know this is not the time, but I don't want to go down there and be like, oh, you need some fucking WD-40. Whoa, what's this?
Damn, something is blocking the drum.
Ah, it's got wedges. Fuck it then. Nice, that was a dope jump. I didn't know if it was gonna let me do that or not.
But which wire to cut?
Oh, dick shit. Okay.
The train's coming! Oh. Whoa, short circuit city.
Well, maybe that's a good thing. Who knows? Shit. Shit. Alright, well. Okay. Well, here's the good news. Okay, so we have the tools for success. Also, yellow wire, not the wire I needed to cut.
But which wire to cut?
Fucking green one. Why not? It's probably orange, though. I don't know. Green is right.
Stupid light. No go. Shit.
No go. Shit. All right, once more.
But which wire to cut?
Oh, it's red, not orange.
Now that's the right cable.
Okay.
Yes, I did it.
Whoa, Jesus. What did that do though?
You okay? You saved me again.
Or was she stuck like in the little track thing?
Now we're totally bonded for life. Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
No! That, though, Jesus, it's too intense for me. Get chill with that shit, game.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar.
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
Oh, shit. Ugh, a dashboard texture. Talk about. OBS isn't yelling at me, but I'm sad I had to turn things down. Enter the Vortex Club. We do fucked up shit.
I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
I love wandering. Okay, so we're back in class, which means now I can get the picture of the chemistry and someone's silhouette.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
Yeah! Like yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Spring break! Woo! Spring break!
You keep walking back and forth. What's your deal, lady? What? Oh, well, fucking excuse me. Go ahead. Keep walking around in circles. Go ahead. Oh, now you're gonna go through the door. Fucking rude. What up, Trevor? Dick!
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
Do you mind if we talk about what happened yesterday with Chloe?
You hit Chloe.
I'm sure she told you why. Did she mention she probably stole one of my guns?
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
Why is this guy trying to be the good guy all of a sudden?
But you treat Kate pretty bad.
You step between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security?
Ooh.
Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I just want peace.
I swear to God, David, if you end up being some kind of savior later in the game, ugh. I'm gonna throw up in my CD drive. Oh, God. Fucking Warren.
Hey, girl. Oh,
Jesus. Oh, God, and he's in the science lab. I need to go.
I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
Look at this fucking guy. I mean, it hasn't even been long, but is this like what a high school is like now? Just fucking people with cell phones all over the place doing shit?
Is this what we've become?
Oh, is it fucking raining? Oh, okay, it is. I was like, what is that god-awful noise? Brooke, I'm not even gonna talk to you because you're pretty annoying. Them beakers, though. Hold on, Warren. I'm trying to take a picture of your chemistry stuff.
Take pictures. I take pretty, pretty pictures.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
Damn it. Really? Really? Okay, fine. What up, douche?
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
Well, what's the mixture? You can't just tell me.
Well, I gotta add one of these ingredients.
Not tell me what you're adding it to. But whatever it is, let's not do potassium, because if you have potassium in water, that's not good. That's how you make an explosion. Potassium is very, very reactive with water. So, sodium.
I have a vision. Go-dium.
Go-dium? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken. Sodium it is.
I don't see a reaction.
Damn. Zip. Nothing.
Alright. I mean, fine. I just didn't know what he was adding it to.
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell Silver.
Yeah. Asking me for
help? Yeah.
Have that either a...
Yeah. Potassium.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but... Go... Potassium.
Oh, God.
Potassium it shall be.
Same pun for both.
This works. You get a free hug.
Oh, God, Warren. Fuck. Whoa, don't breathe that.
Weird science.
Move your face. Don't. What are you doing? Ah, Jesus, guy. There's something else.
Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck.
What the fuck did he just
say? Bring me the brain, Igor.
Oh, hold on. I could swear. Yeah, right? I should make sure. Game. Because I don't have to go to science class. So, like, now or never.
I bet if I touch the glass, all these creepy sea critters will pop up.
Also won't be too happy with you. Tapping on the glass. Like this says, Max. What up, Miss Grant?
Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max.
Where are you?
It's too bad you didn't sign the petition.
I'm so sorry.
Every signature counts. And yours might be the one that decided.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are no dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
I could've.
Unless you want a face full of powder, I would add chlorine.
Hmm.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must know Mr. Jefferson pretty well by now.
I certainly know him as a talented artist and terrific teacher. I've been here a little longer, but he's made a bigger mark. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
Mm-hmm.
What about that snow yesterday? What's your scientific explanation?
Hit me with it, teach.
Our climate is moving beyond explanation. Of course, some of the tribes here might see it different.
That's what you got for me? Is there any way I can still sign it?
How's your campaign going?
All right, clearly not.
It's missing somebody who should care. But no finger pointing
at me. I'll sign it right now.
More people would rather send a text than sign a petition.
God, sorry,
That's
I forgot.
That's how they keep us all distracted. Nobody will notice cameras on every square foot.
Some of us want to use our cameras for good.
But people like David Mattson want to use them to spy.
Jeez, I'm not like him, Miss Grant.
I know, Max. But the trick is to make sure Blackwell Academy does not end up like him.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Just for shoots and googles, I do want to test that theory. Going back. Is that far enough? Not 100%.
Hey, Warren.
Yes.
Maxwell Silver.
Asking me for a...
Have that either...
How about you, Ed? Lots of potassium. Lots of potassium. That's amazing.
Wow, Warren. You need to add chlorine. Not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it.
Whoa.
Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
Oh, you guys really broke the bounds of science.
Nice.
That was fun helping Warren. He's pretty cute when he's in full-on geek mode.
Ah, shit! Max has fallen for him. I knew it. Ah, oh, biscuits. Oh, cool. So that's the pick. Alright, sweet. Shit. There's no buenos. There's no buenos at all. Darn it. Confound it. Alright. Now, I mean, if... Alright, dubstep bros, so if we keep going down this way... We're gonna...
Can't help me.
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
No.
Why? You don't understand mine.
Hey.
Nobody does.
Hey, Kate.
Nobody.
Hey, Kate.
Stop.
Kate.
Don't come near me.
Well, all right. Fucking sorry, people. Oh, that's it. Thought we were going somewhere with that. Yeah. Well, I guess that's all, folks. What up, Teach? Oh, what's in here? Oh! Well, son of a bitch. What up, Jeff?
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Oh, boy.
Sure. You look worried. Is everything okay?
Nah, sorry, man. Shit's pretty you, real. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul.
One way
do
of putting it.
Proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
Oh my god, that happened.
It did happen. Nathan Prescott had a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday.
This is a serious accusation.
No shit!
You don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I'd like to believe that, Max.
I'd like to believe that, but I just
suck. There's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen,
you.
Should I?
Excuse me, Max.
Excuse me, my telephone is more important than my students.
Yes?
Fucking guy.
Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Mm-hmm. So fucking important.
I want to teach students, but if they come to me with their problems, I refuse to help them.
Well, now you get to wait.
Sure.
Hey, Mixer. Mm-hmm, darn right. I'm gonna wait for you, too.
Hey, I'll do that.
Ugh.
This guy. All the adults in this town are really just ruining it. All a bunch of jerks. Fine, I'll go to class. Hey, look.
Make me beautiful, Nathan.
It's that one chick. He got hit with toilet paper. I am. Daniel!
What's up, Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on.
Paparazzi on. What up?
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
Jesus, I see.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give.
What up, faggot?
We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
Yep, sure I am.
Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
We're here.
You can wait, motherfucker. You're gonna get your one, and so are you too, Victoria. And slut butt. Both of you are gonna get your what? What the fuck happened to your face? Who clawed this nigga? See that? Good. Fuck you. Loser. sit at my desk. Can't even be safe at my private academy. People bringing guns and shit. Oh, Jesus, Kate's walking in the rain. Oh, no.
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now, this is so wrong and weird.
Yo, can we get... Hold up. No, get the fuck up. Gotta get a picture of that, right? Ah, oh, damn it. Hold on, wait. Can I? Damn it. No. Wait. Darn it. Fucking Warren.
What up, Max?
What
up? I saw
up?
Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate
oh,
has
shit.
A lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
Maybe
down.
I'll
we
see
have
you
a
later.
Lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
Whoa.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we... We can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example.
Yep.
Who I know can't wait to enter, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in monochrome.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girl's dorm!
Zachary,
check it.
Do not
oh,
come into my
fuck.
Class like that ever again. Listen,
waiting for this.
Everybody remain seated.
She's on the roof.
Dismissed.
Jesus fucking Christ, people, are you making a spectacle of this?
Kate?
Oh, fuck.
No! Oh, God.
No!
Ah! She can't die.
Ah.
She can't.
Ah. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Not again. Not now.
No. Ah!
I have to try something.
Ah!
I won't be able to rewind again and again.
Ah! Oh no.
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
Excuse me, birds. There's too much fuck going on right now. I don't know what I could possibly even think to do.
Power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously?
Seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please. You don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm already on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Nobody cares, Kate. There'll be another viral Victoria video in a day, and everybody will forget.
You can't scrub my video from the internet. And that's how I'll be remembered. Unless I jump.
Kate, you can't do this to all the people who care about you.
No. Nobody cares about me. Nobody.
No, but we talked about this. Fuck, she has sisters and brothers? Shit!
What about your brother, Kate? You'll destroy her. She doesn't care about a video. She loves you.
You don't know my mother at all. She already thinks Satan has me on the fast track to hell. Let's prove it.
Oh, no, no!
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us, but we have to go over what happened before Miss Marsh, before she did what she did. Officer Barry will be taking notes for the official police inquiry. I'm sure you'll give him your full cooperation.
Such a tragedy.
But there must be a reason for everything. We need to find out why Kate Marsh would be driven to such desperate action. As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duty seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, Why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
I have so many issues with this right now. Jesus fucking Christ. One, I definitely thought I had her on the fast track. I thought we were good. Two, how are they gonna throw some more shit at me already? I have not even composed myself, and all that bullshit the principal just spouted. I care about my students. Fuck you, guy. You don't give a shit. You care about the money, and the money's sitting the fuck in front of you. So if I tell them that Nathan dosed her, no one's gonna fucking believe me, because she's not even alive anymore to do anything about it. If she were here, we would have a better story to go on, but she's not, and it's me who was for some reason on the rooftop with her, which is now weird, and she's dead. Jesus fucking Christ. It's the only one I want to go with, though. The other ones are just not even...
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her.
What up, G Disney?
She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and revealed.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit. Something happened to her and you know it.
right and blah, blah, blah. And then I think she comes down. Because you did everything else right except that.
See, my problem with it was...
There was also some scripture that you could have looked at and, like, quoted into her.
Damn it. See, my biggest problem with, like, saying her dad is, like, I looked at it and I was like, okay, she's a church girl. And I knew that meant that pretty much her mom and her dad probably both sucked. But I was like, her dad probably sucks a lot more. So let's go with the mom.
Her dad was actually the better one.
Damn it. That killed me a little bit. I was not fucking ready for that today.
Guess what? That's like, that's kind of heavy comparatively to a lot of the other shit because she's dead as fuck. But like, it gets way heavier.
I was also just like, they set it up really good because I knew it was going to come at some point. I was like, this chick is either going to kill herself or something like that's going to happen. I knew it was going to happen, but I wasn't ready for that. And I definitely wasn't ready for them to make it a permanent decision for me. That fucked me up because I was panicked. I was like,
I got so lucky.
They made it like a real situation. Like, you got one fucking chance at this.
Yeah. Caitlin somehow managed to keep her alive too.
God damn, though. But it does make sense if this whole power, with this whole power thing, because that would mean that she can change these minimal things, which seem to not have too much of an effect, but someone dying, she cannot prevent that. That's fucking Jesus, though.
Yeah, like, dude, that kind of like hurt to watch. Like, that was pretty fucking rough. Ooh.
I don't like suicide.
I saw the fucking... I saw, like, the conversation start to turn. I was like, oh, no.
Yeah, like, everything was fine. It was good. I was pounded out. I was like, now, granted, the way that Max was going about it is a little weird. It sounded a little selfish. She was like, well, I did this for you, and I did this for you. And I mean, it's cool, but I was just like, I got her. I was just pounding them in. I was like, look at all this shit I've done for you. And she was like, well... yes, you are the greatest. And I was like, see, let's get down. And she was like, but wait, nobody loves me. And I was like, but no, we went over this. And then all downhill.
Oh, that's so shit.
All downhill over one thing. Son of a bitch. Oh, Kate Marsh. And I needed her for that last part. Oh, that's going to make this whole investigate. That's going to make this just so much harder not having her around.
Oh, man.
Gah.
That was... wow.
So, as much as it may be early and I'm all about, you know, fuck yeah, let's pound through this because I still love this game. I think a little break is definitely...
Yeah, that would probably be good.
A little day break between these is definitely a good thing because, if it's going to be that, Jesus Christ.
Oh, dude, the fucking next episode? Oh, my God, dude. Your butt is not prepared.
Like, that whole train thing panicked me. But that wasn't too bad, especially because, once I found out I could keep the items when I rewound, I was like, oh, pff, got this. Simple. But, I don't know what to think about Marsden, though, because I feel like, only because it's like a TV trope, but it's a game trope.
About what?
The security guard, David Marsden or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Because I feel like he's one of those characters that they build you the fucking hate him. Be like, this fucking guy's a dick. I hate him. I hope he dies. But then in the end, it turns out he was the good guy and trying to just help the whole time type deal.
Yeah.
But I really don't want that to happen. Just like I really didn't want this Warren thing to happen. But if the game's gonna shove it on me, then I guess I'll be nicer to fucking Warren. Yeah. I didn't want to, but Max fell into his trap and his smooth words not only once, but twice. So, looks like it's happening. All right. Oh, I couldn't save Kate. Well, fucking God, I'm in the negative percentile on that. So, let's see. Most people, yep, told Kate to wait for two. I feel like most people rationale that, especially nowadays with the idea of, like, if you don't have something solid, no one's going to fucking believe
fucking
you.
Fucking Caitlin was like, go to the police. I was like, damn, bitch.
Yeah, it's like, yes, it's that whole thing of, like, that's why I said becoming part of the statistic. It's like that whole thing of, like, you know, this many of things go uncalled. And, like, that's kind of why. It sucks, but, you know, fucking here we are.
Yo, think about all the dickheads that didn't answer her call, though.
Yeah, that's savage. Only because I was like, Chloe's not going to walk away. I'm going to answer this phone call because some real shit's going on. And then we'll be right back. It's fine. Just give me literally 2 seconds. Tried to shoot Frank. Most people did. Interesting. Blamed Nathan. Everybody. Duh.
Yeah.
The people that did said David, I understand. The ones who said Mr. Jefferson, I can only assume that they were just like, I mean...
he fucking could have done something.
Yeah, they were like, it's my only other one.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. So...
Well, there's another... There should be a longer page of shit if you hit...
Let's see. Oh, here we are. Got it. Alrighty. I also assume you've learned by now you should definitely mute your shit. Otherwise, you'll go insane.
There we go. There it is.
Oh, man. So, let's see. Watered my plant. Duh. I need to try to keep remembering to do that each episode. Hopefully, Mom reminds me every time. Didn't help Alyssa. Oh, yeah.
You fucking dickhead.
I couldn't. I had to. I weren't friendly with Taylor. We were not friendly with Taylor. That's weird.
Yeah, she's waiting by a bench and like you can like she talks like you're saying shit to each other and she's like, yeah, my mom's sick, and then you can rewind time and then go, yeah, I heard your mom's sick, it's gonna be okay and shit. Another thing that I fucking like randomly stumbled upon.
Of course everyone accepted Warren's invitation because they just love it.
Fucking Caitlin didn't, but that's probably because she was just being a big old lesbian for fucking Chloe.
Hell yeah, but two, fuck Warren. I just can't.
Oh, no.
I can't with that guy. let's see. I didn't write a message. Where could I have written? Oh, see, I thought about that, but I didn't like see a marker like in the immediate vicinity, and I didn't search. I didn't tamper with the rail tracks. I didn't? Thought I did.
I don't even know what that was.
Thought that's exactly what the fuck I did.
No, you fucking saved, like, you fucking...
I honestly don't know what I did then. If I didn't tamper the rail tracks, I don't know what I did.
I fucking cut the wire right, like, the first time. I was like, oh, Jesus Christ.
All right, I didn't gain entrance to the party. Yeah, I really don't care. Helped Warren. Yep. You told on David to Mr. Jefferson. Darn tootin'. Oh, man.
Yeah, dude. Shit's rough.
This is still great, though.
Fucking... And then, like, there's no fucking, like... Oh. Now there's no brake pedal. It's just like shit is just getting fucking like pedaled to the floor.
Ooh.
Like episode 3 is some real heavy emotional shit, and then 4 and 5 is just like your mind is being skull fucked by a big black dick.
Okay, that thing just scared me way too much. And also,
wait, what?
The little preview for the next episode.
Oh, what was it?
It was like, it did a few second shots of them walking through the school after hours with flashlights,
and then
someone shines a flashlight on them.
Yep. Scooby doing it.
But I don't like this next set of pictures. We got Weird House going through the school at night and the creepy RV that the cop told me about.
You ain't even ready. Like, this is a very artistic, like, story. It's real good. It's all real good.
I want it.
You know, I'm telling you, Travis, we're going to get to episode 4, and I'm going to be like, just stop here and never play this game ever again, Travis. I'm warning you right now, leave it alone.
Because, dude, that... this game did, like I said, very well with the pacing and the atmosphere. Enough to the point that, like, I'm not... It's very hard for me to get, like, a middle-aged woman on a soap opera attached to characters and stuff. The way, like... Only because I'm streaming right now did I just hold everything together and sit firm right here. Like, I just stayed silent. I was just like...
I know, because, like, you're talking through all the fun shit, and then you just got, like, super quiet during that.
Oh, that fucked me up. Like I said, I cannot do suicide shit. And watching her fall two times before I even got to go up to the roof fucked me up. And then I got
to
the roof.
You were so fucked up, you weren't even rewinding as she was falling. You're like, ugh!
Yeah, I was just oh, man. Because, you know, Max said it right. It just looked like a weight falling through the air. Didn't even look real.
That was pretty rough. Now, like, I'm pretty depressed. Like, that was pretty fucked up.
I'm going to put this on right now.
I'm going to have fucking trouble sleeping tonight.
Still early. Do you want to play anything before I just...
We can play, like, a few games of Rocket League before I go to sleep.
Yeah, I can do that. We'll just make it.
You work tomorrow?
No, I just gotta go in for a, I'm doing a department supervisor interview tomorrow.
Tattoo tomorrow after work, so.
After work?
However long, yeah.
Hit me up.
However long.
And I'll probably come by.
Alright, I'm going to, Heroes
and
Ghost. Yeah, Derek's coming down too.
Cool beans. Yeah, I'll probably stop by then.
Yep.
Gonna change this.
That's gonna be a fun thing.
Try to end this stream on a lighthearted note. Shit just got real. Chill time. Playing. Man, I wish I could just put FAP at League. Alright. That was fucking nuts, though. I was still trying to process all the things that just happened.
Yeah, dude, it's not good. Nothing's good. Everything is bad. Oh, wow.
Where is... Oh, yeah. There you go. And it's not World of Warcraft this time.
I'm so afraid, like, somebody's just gonna come in your stream.
And what?
And just spoil everything?
Yeah, no, that's why I'm really trying to hold true. And that's also a side note, if you weren't hip to the knowings, as a moderator, you see that
hey,
shit.
Hey, dudes.
Oh,
my God. You're scary.
So
welcome to the stream, guy.
Oh, let me fucking turn you down because I'm dying.
But, yeah, as a moderator, it's your job. If you see someone spoilery, you fucking delete
that
shit. Well, you can. I think you can just time them out, which is like you see the two options next to the names.
Okay. So
yeah, ban user and
timeout.
Yeah, I think timing them out will do it.
But how do I get rid of that specific message?
Deleting messages. That is officially unbeknownst to me. Oh, what do you got, Noggin? Do you know? Are you hip and aware?
When you time out people, the messages are automatically deleted.
Oh, really?
Yeah, cool. So, yeah, then just, yeah, I guess just fucking time them out.
Because yours is delayed, too, from seeing theirs, right?
No, the chat is instantaneous. It's just like if I were to ask you a question, you're going to hear it later.
Different.
Yeah, but I can see chat as soon as things happen.
Okay.
That's why I can watch chat reactions, because something can happen, and then I can watch chat, and then I can see when you guys see it, and then people are like, oh, fucking shit!
Oh god, I need to turn the fuck down out of Rocket League.
James, you want to play some FAPIT League?
Yeah,
I'm so bad, but sure. Shut up, Matt. Can I have a second to respond? Shit.
No. That was way too long. It was a yes or no question.
Oh, and son, I don't know how much of that you saw or watched, but shit just got so real. I can't.
Yeah, you is what I was saying before my mic got unplugged.
Okay. So, are you talking to me, Travis?
About yes, sir.
The game? No, because I want to watch. I don't know if like the episodes like coincide with each other.
Yeah, coming so in episode two would be a little weird.
How would I play it?
Best.
It is
Telltale games.
It's not Telltale. Not Telltale at all. I don't like Telltale games. This is like it's essentially like The Last of Us type storytelling where just everything's interactable. But this one, instead of, you know, being in a post-apocalyptic world, you're a senior at a private academy and shit just gets fucking real.
That's pretty cool.
I'm not even gonna blow the main trope of the whole game out of the water. I like the idea of finding.
Is it like Heavy Rain?
No, Heavy Rain is gay.
I know.
like it. Where is that invite? I didn't even.
Yeah, send me an invite, fuckface.
Man, we're all just sitting here like jerking off.
Yeah, I guess I'll do that.
Yeah, man, you are the master Rocket Leaguer.
Oh, is that true?
I mean,
like, I feel like, oh, man, I don't even know. We're gonna get shit on in standard because I'm fucking like Div 4, Challenger 3.
Me too, guy. Yeah, okay. He thinks I didn't ride off him and other friends' coattails. I did. I'm up there.
Oh shit! All right.
Oh shit!
I got my car back in time.
His name is Homeless.
Oh, then we got him. He's homeless. He doesn't
super
know how to
homeless
drive a
lunchbox.
Car.
Yeah, fuck off me, Holmes.
Oh
my
I'm
God.
So sorry. I'm gonna actually, hold on. I have to do something then.